I'm working in the accordion, in Virginia accordion factory since I was 5 years old. What means that I met all the artists coming in the factories, and my father welcomed them, and I was always around him and watch and listening to the music. And day by day, my love for the accordion growing up with me. And what I'm doing? I'm doing marketing for the factory, so I prepare all the catalogs and events, the website and information, Facebook, and all the future meeting with the artist. So this is my world, and I played accordion since when I was
That was my next question. Do
I
you play yourself accordion?
played when I was a child. It was a magic moment because the accordion brings people together, and we had an accordion orchestra, and was in the 70s, and we played already Aida and classical music, and the people waiting for a valzer, a polka, but we was ready for classical concert, so we were just already in the future when we was child.
And do you remember the name of your first accordion teacher?
Yes, of course, it's Edgardo Muñoz,
Okay,
so
from Castelfidardo?
from Loreto,
Okay,
and
very close.
yes, it was really a visionary.
And so since all these years you are, because I see you in every festival, so you are regularly in contact with all the artists seen now?
Yes, of course, it's my joy and my energy because they have always something interesting to teach, and they give me richness, and my soul is really full of new ideas and few energy for the future.
And that's very interesting. And do you see any relation between your own personal relationship with the artist and the evolution of the accordion itself?
Again.
Do you see any relation with your personal relation with the artist and the evolution of the instrument itself?
Of course, because every new pieces, new composition, and new way of playing, I mean playing music, needs every day the best attention for new ideas and new product. But I think that for now the instrument is like well done product. I mean well done instrument, like a grand piano coda and so on. Of course every day we make a
Improve,
new we
of course.
improve we improve but I think we are
Close to the perfection.
ready. No, perfection never,
No. Okay.
never. Also for you, for your artist, every day is a challenge, every day is a new sensation, so we have to follow you, and we are on the stage like you, so we feel a little bit artist with you because you are on the stage and we are on the stage with you.
Yeah, I trust you, and I remember this big emotion we had together. It was just before COVID. We were in Argentina. It was a fantastic moment with this artist who plays chamamé. You remember? Yeah, and we had the same emotion on the concert. So you are close to the very nice, beautiful instrument. Can you present it, that baby?
Oh, this is a Simba instrument. This is fantastic for children,
Yeah.
and so they can start at 3, 4 years old. Is indestructibile. I don't know in English how they say.
You cannot break it.
Yes, and it's just 2 kilos, and so they can make noise.
Yeah. And you cannot break it. That's
Yeah,
perfect.
that's
And
it.
when did you begin the production of this instrument? It's quite new.
It was an idea, and he pushed so much was Erkki Järvenpää from Finland, so it was his intention to give the power to the children, and I think it's already 15 years old ago. 15 years
15
ago.
years ago. Okay, I
Yeah.
have never seen it, but I will, after the interview, I will touch it. I want to
Yes,
try.
please make noise.
And I will make noise. Okay, thank you so much, Francesca, for this first interview. Now we will discover the other part of the Piccini Factory.
Grazie, arrivederci.